Okay, so those of you who don't know me, I'm Raju, and I'm a little bit active in the Debian community. So we are having a session on setting up own cloud. So why do you need an own cloud server, or why do you need to use this particular software? Because you want your data under your own control. Most of you you have used services like Dropbox, Google Drive, OneDrive for Microsoft, SkyDrive now. So you trust the corporations with your data. You don't have any way by which you can take your data under your own control. You don't actually know where the servers are located, or you don't know where who is accessing your data. Recently, a lot of revelations have been made by Julian Assange, by Edward Snowden, on that your data is being accessed by the American government, by Indian government, by the security agency NSA of US, and also UK government. So you are you a terrorist? So you should not let your privacy be interfered by anyone. So the way by which we take our data under our control is by setting up our own servers for data storage. Our own servers in our local network, in our college, in our community. And by the way you will do it is by the software OwnCloud. So the latest version of OwnCloud is 8.2, and I just finished the slides fastly in 5 minutes. So it is new for you, then you can go get it. Okay. I told you why and what of OwnCloud. Okay, next. Awesomeness of the cloud, back. Accessible everywhere. If you have set it on a local network, you can access it on the local network. If you have set it up on a server, on some which is accessible over the web, you will also be able to access the cloud over the web. It has a backup. You can also share easy sharing and collaboration, all free. You can also do server to server sharing. So let's say if you are on Google Drive and the other guy is on Dropbox, you can't directly share your data. You have to download that file and upload it to some other server. Here you can do server to server sharing. Two servers or more servers backing up their data between each other, or backing up some part of some files between them. You can do that. Next. Powerfulness of the cloud. I have already discussed. You don't know where your data is, who is accessing your data, where is your data being used. And your data tells a lot about more about you than just your information. What kind of files you have, what kind of documents you are having. If you are showing some confidential documents in there, they will know all about you. Next. So that is what I said about NSA. We are all vulnerable to everyone because the NSA wanted us to be vulnerable to them. The infrastructure around us is developed in such a way that they don't want us to be completely private. They want us, our data, to be accessible. Everything is developed in such a way. So, and we take back our privacy using open source softwares, using OwnCloud, using Debian. So let's go ahead, take back your data. Okay, next. Some of its features: sync and share, open source, easy to use, easy to install. Easy to install. How easy to install? We'll see. Next. Any of you guys have any experience with LAMP? Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP. The four things. So you might have installed Apache or MySQL.
Yes.
Or some of you might have been, you who are in development, have used PHP. So we need a LAMP stack. We call it as a LAMP stack, the four softwares. We need a LAMP stack in order to configure OwnCloud, right? All platforms, and it can also be installed on most computers. So you can also install it on, let's say you want a server at your home, you can install it on a Raspberry Pi or a BeagleBone and let it be there on all the time. So I take a lot of photos on my phone. I'll get back to my home. As soon as I enter in my network, all my phone or photos from my phone will automatically get backed up on that particular server. Next. Backside now. So you see the platforms for it, which it is available: Mac, Android, Windows, Linux, any tablet, phone, desktop or laptop. Next. With own cloud, you can actually also connect to the to other cloud storage servers, proprietary cloud storage servers like Dropbox, WebDAV or simple FTP servers. Encryption, which is not present in other services, and server-to-server sharing of links, passwords, that is also available with others. Next. Yeah, this is an interesting part. Most of the open source softwares are extended using add-ons or extensions. You can extend your browser, you can add features, functionalities to your Firefox browser or Chrome browser using add-ons, right? You can also do it if you are using GNOME, there is actually called extensions.gnome.org. You add a lot of features to your UI. Similarly, for OwnCloud, there are a lot of extensions available on apps.owncloud.com. So you want to write a document without using a Office software, you just need to access your server, a document editor is already installed on it, and just by using the web interface, you can actually make a document. And a lot of those features can be configured with your OwnCloud software. Next. It's open source, it has a lot of users, it has been here since 2010. All its source code is available on github.com/owncloud. Next. New network tool, next. The UI part which we will actually see, next. Next. Actions brain model, next, next, next. Gallery sorting, yeah, pan and zoom. New for admins, ticket. New for devs, get it. Some websites where we will actually be going out, next. Questions? Yeah. Close this. Now we get back to the actual work. So the version of OwnCloud which is available in the repositories of Debian or Ubuntu is actually version 7, and the latest version is 8.2. So we won't be installing from the repositories. Installing from repository sets up everything for us, but that is old, and we want the latest version. So all of you guys who are having the web browser, the terminal, so go to your terminals. When I said we can only configure OwnCloud on LAMP stack, I meant it, because you can't configure OwnCloud on a Windows server. You specifically need a Linux server. I'm not sure whether you can you can do it on a Mac machine, but you can definitely do it on a Linux server. Point but control. Visible from the back side? Yeah. So, first component of LAMP, what it is? Linux. We already have Linux. What is the second component?
Apache.
Apache. What is the package name for Apache?
Apache Tomcat.
Nah.
Apache 2.
When you install it by apt-get, what is the package name?
Apache
2. So what you will do? You will do apt-get install Apache 2. For those of you who use Software Center, they can also install it using the Software Center. So go to your terminal, right? Sudo apt-get install Apache 2. Madhu Sudan.
Using the
I'm not sure about that.
Just
why?
It'll be faster.
Have you guys set up the repositories? We have a local cache of applications on Rigvay's machine. So if you set up this file, you can actually download the files from Rigvay's machine. And that would be a lot faster. Apache is already installed. Have you guys managed to install it? So go to answer, they accept. Okay. Apache hua?
Yes.
This case mein downloading ka, is it taking a lot of size to download it? I told you, get it connected first. Is it installed?
Installed.
Okay.
No, the temp server full.
Yes.
Installed, done. उसका help कर उसका laptop लेके जा ठीक है. We got L, we got A. What is M?
MySQL.
What is the package name?
MySQL.
The package name is MySQL hyphen server and MySQL hyphen client. Install both these packages. Client. While installing MySQL, it may ask you for a database name or password, and just remember whatever the password you entered. Anyone having any questions or doubts or any technical difficulties? एक बार रिपोजिटरी सेट करो, रिपोजिटरी से फास्ट हो जाएगा. एक बार 5 मिनट रोक के एक बार कर लो जो भी सेटअप करना है. वो दिख रहा है फाइल, आपको वो चीज ऐड करनी है उस जगह पे, और वो ये पूरा लाइन लिखना है उस फाइल के अंदर. फर्स्ट लाइन जो में जो लिखा है इस डायरेक्टरी में जाके ये फाइल नेम बनाना है आपको, ठीक है. नैनो से या फिर विम से वीआई से ये फाइल बनाओ, और उस फाइल के अंदर ये कंटेंट डालना है.
But a lot of them have not.
And the IP is
changed. Okay.
So what is the plan? 321.
Take 2 to 3 minutes and do it. Fast. किसका नहीं हो रहा? 01 APT CHER-NG.
APT के बाद क्या है?
कोई ऐसा जिसको डिफिकल्टी हो रही है सेट करने में? You have to make this file using some text editor. हाँ, सुडो पूरा लिख दिया होगा ना, उसे नहीं हुआ होगा. हुआ किसी को कोई डिफिकल्टी नहीं हो रहा है? हो गया. एक वायर का एक एप्लीकेशन ही रखना है ना?
हाँ, एक एप्लीकेशन.
Right, yeah. Just,
semicolon. After adding this, do we need to do an admin update? Or it will take it? किस किस का नहीं हुआ? पीछे हो गया? हाँ ना?
So,
So you have to open up the dot, go to download, you get this dialog. Download any, whichever is smaller, download tar.bz2 or tar.zip. Save file. Shorter. Download tar.bz2, it will download faster. And save it to some good folder, so you know where it is downloaded. In downloads or something. Dinesh, चल रहा है क्या तेरे पास?
किसका?
तो ऑफलोड के यू आर एस के आईपी एड्रेस ऐड कर सकते हैं, आईपी के अंदर वो ऐड कर दे सेटिंग में और कॉन्फिग डॉट पीएचपी ठीक है. आपका डाउनलोड चल रहा है सबका? कितना टाइम लगा डाउनलोड के लिए?
19 12 मिनट 30 सेकंड.
जस्ट अ मिनट. यू ऑल विल हैव इट
जस्ट 1 मिनट. तेलीज में नहीं है काम का स्टॉल. अच्छा ठीक है. सब
Who's having a lot of downloading time on the browser, just go to your browser and open the IP 192 on your browser 192.168.255.132/owncloud. You got this URL? जिसका डाउनलोडिंग का टाइम लग रहा है वो इस URL पे जाओ.
क्या URL
है? तेरे सिस्टम पे जा, एक गेस्ट अकाउंट बना और उसके अंदर ओनक्लाउड का फाइल डाल दे. You got this page? Yes, you know. वही शेयर कर रहा हूँ. ठीक है, डाउनलोड कर लो. 255.132. तू लोकल 127 पे डाउनलोड कर, लॉगिन कर जल्दी से. लोकल में कितना कम चल रहा है? एक ही
नहीं
बाकी का अपने आवाज आएगा सिर्फ स्लैश ऑन कर. अगेन यूजर नेम, एक मिनट का यूजर नेम आ रहा है। यूजरनेम राजू, पासवर्ड 12345, एंटर। नाउ यू हैव गॉट अ ओनक्लाउड 8.2.2.zip देयर, द थर्ड फाइल। हां, जस्ट डाउनलोड दैट फाइल। इफ यू डाउनलोड फास्टर सिंस इट्स ऑन अ लोकल नेटवर्क, सेफ फाइल। See, the local network file is downloading in some seconds. Raju, password 12345. Hey, we are running out of time. Fast karo. Raju, space one, password 12345. कितने लोगों को डाउनलोड हो गया? जिनका डाउनलोड हो गया फाइल को साइन आउट कर दो। ओके, जिनका डाउनलोड हो गया है, जिनका नहीं हुआ वो लोग देखो यहाँ पे कैसे क्या कर रहे हैं हम लोग, ताकि वो परफॉर्म कर सके। ठीक है, आगे बढ़े। ठीक है, नाउ अभी जो फाइल डाउनलोड होगा उसको एक्सट्रैक्ट करना है। जिसका डाउनलोड होगा एक्सट्रैक्ट करो, हम लोग डाउनलोड होने का वेट करते हैं। पीछे का चल रहा है पर हाँ, तो लेकिन वो लोकल से चल रहा है। लोकल से भी वो कंप्लीट कर रहा है, वो देखा ऊपर वाला लोकल से डाउनलोड हो रहा है। फास्ट हो गया, अभी वो 557 के भी ले गया,
तब से वो हट
गया। वो नेट वाला बंद है, वो नेट वाला बंद पॉज कर रहा है। ओके, किसका डाउनलोड नहीं हो रहा है? अभी भी लॉगिन हुआ पेज हो रहा है, क्या दे रहा है? एरर
नहीं दे रहा,
और किसको चाहिए?
क्या फाइल है?
ठीक है, बाकी जिनका नहीं बार बोलोगे इधर देखो, ध्यान रखो हम लोग क्या क्या कर रहे हैं। हम लोग उसको एक्सट्रैक्ट करेंगे, जहां पे भी डाउनलोड हुआ है उसको वहीं पे एक्सट्रैक्ट करो। सो वी हैव गॉट इट एक्सट्रैक्टेड, यहां तक हुआ। कोई मुझे मतलब थोड़ा ये रिप्लाइज देते रहो, हाँ हुआ नहीं हुआ, फास्ट हो रहा है स्लो हो रहा है, हाँ मुझे पता रहेगा। ठीक है, जहाँ पे wherever we have extracted the folder, just move to that folder in your terminal. Don't get into uncle.
Yeah,
just unzip.
Yeah. Command link.
Yeah. Now. You can extract it using your GUI or on your terminal using unzip space your zip file name. How many have you got it downloaded, extracted, and in your terminal you are into that folder? Done? Okay, now we move forward. What we do is, first tell me, you have got Apache installed. How do you verify whether your Apache is installed or not? Whether your web server is running or not? Localhost. Go to your browser. What is your localhost IP? You have an IP for your own computer. If you are not connected to any other network, you have an IP for your own network card. What is that IP? 1. So enter that IP. Enter. Now you get a Apache web server page. Now where is this web page saved? Anyone knows the path? Where is this web page saved? I'm looking to be that a lot of people are being left behind. The flow. So what is the location of this web page? Okay, so we have to move our own cloud folder into the folder where this web page is saved. So how we do it, we go to terminal. So we have the OwnCloud folder.
So what I did is,
So how do we move it? We move it using MV for move. Move MV space OwnCloud. We want to move the OwnCloud folder. We want to move it where? In slash var slash dplw slash html. Enter. Sudo. And we have got it done here. Done? Two done? Three? 0.0.1. How many people completed? move the folder to /var/www/html. Done? Now, now what we do is, we go to so we have moved a folder to a system, our own folder to a system folder. Now we need to add permissions to our folder so that it can be accessed by all other programs without needing any root access. So what we, if you go to the browser now and you enter your localhost IP /homecloud, see what you get. What do you get? Here we are getting can't write into config directory because it is not having access to that directory, permissions to access that directory. So we need to add the permissions. How do we add the permissions? Go to the command. Done? क्या ठीक है वो आराम से करेंगे वो अपने पास ठीक है आगे लेट्स मूव अहेड आगे आप लोगों को समझ रहा अभी तक क्या क्या चल रहा स्टेप बाय स्टेप मैंने क्लियर की दिया नाउ व्हाट वी डू इज ट्रिपल डब्ल्यू स्लैश ट्रिपल डब्ल्यू नीचे नीचे सब चला सो वी यूज दिस कमांड चेंज ओनरशिप माइनस आर इज सम पैरामीटर and this is www data so any folder which is inside the www folder is being given access to be accessible by anyone by any software and the path where our folder is so our folder is under the own cloud in the HTML folder it is done now reload that page Now what do you get?
Yeah.
Only CH root ka step
nahi kiya, but still we are here.
You are in a CH root. CH root has no root.
Root
menu. Sudo kya? Hello. Root menu.
We are not a root.
So you have moved the folder to variable
register. Yes.
ठीक है हमारे पास टाइम बचा है बहुत कम तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे वी विल फिनिश दिस राइट ओके एंड एवरीवन शुड सी हाउ वी आर डूइंग इट एंड लेटर ऑन व्हाट आर द स्टेप्स यू आर रिमेनिंग विद वी कैन सॉर्ट इट आउट समवेयर
नहीं
चलेगा now what errors we are getting now we need to resolve these errors okay so if you zoom there is a module which is php module gd not installed okay Okay, now we need to resolve this error. What is the module? PHP module GD. So we need to install a package which will resolve this error. The package name is ESP5-GD. So apt-get install ESP5-GD. Enter. Now again go to that page. What is the second error? PHP module curl not installed. So install php5-curl. Got it? PHP5-GD, PHP5-curl. Restart some web services. We need to restart Apache 5. How do we restart it? Anyone knows it?
Sudo
Apache.
Sudo? Sudo Apache.
There are two ways. One is using services slash Apache 2 space Apache 2 space restart. The other is exact path to that program and then restart. Since you already know the first way, I'll do the second way. So we do this. You already know this. Let's do the other way. Sudo space slash etc slash init dot d slash apache 2 space restart. This is the second way. Now again load the old page. No if you are getting the drivers issue, install the package php5-mysql. Guys, we need to finish fast. Let's take a look here. Okay. So we installed php5-jd, php5-curl, php5-mysql. That was for php and php5. We installed Apache 2, we installed Apache, MySQL, PHP, we moved OwnCloud to the folder, and now we have got a server instance ready to being set up. Now we will set up a admin account here. So create an admin account, make it admin, or you can use it something else. Admin, password, something, whatever you want to use. Get down. Data folder is where your OwnCloud folder is. Get down. Now you want a database user. Make it OwnCloud.
The database error is still there.
Give me the restart. Apache 5. Apache 2 restart.
php5-mysql करने के बाद restart.
A database password, something that you are setting it, so any password. Database name, we don't know. Okay, now finish that. Everyone, so saw this? Okay, OwnCloud use your username for each database request, which is of your system. Yes. Yeah. Or if it, your username doesn't work, use the root. Your old cloud can admin the password. We got it done. Who else has got it done?
Service.
And we have 4 minutes. So in 4 minutes, we'll take an overview of the look of the admin interface and a user interface. Okay. We still need to do a few things. Like okay. So what we do is close this. Okay. So this is the admin interface. Whoever is remaining with the setup, we can do it later. I'm here. Later as well. Just take a look at the screen. So this is the default interface. You have used a similar interface all with Dropbox, Google Drive and stuff. So I don't think you can easily manage this. Let's go to admin, go to users. Here you create the users which will be accessing your cloud. So let's say I will be accessing the cloud from some machine, and I need an account on this. So you will create, you write my name there, admin Raju, paste some password, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, groups. Groups is an important thing, which is expand to group. Yeah. So I can classify the type of my users. So home, so I'll have a group home, and I will only let my family access the cloud, and I will have friends, so friends will be in a different group. So I will have users as home, users as friends. So if I want to share some data, I can specify the type of users. So I want to share the data with my friends, so no one from my family would be able to access that particular data. So admin friend, okay, thank you, great. So now we have a user, Raju. For Raju, we have groups. There is group admin. If he wants to make me an administrator of the user as of the server as well, I'll use group admin. Group admin for. Okay, and the other thing, quota. How much space of data is reserved for some particular user? So I want to give someone very less usage, or I want to have 10 GB or more for someone else. So I can all specify it here. Okay, next. Next, admin user. Then go to admin. Yep. Here we specify a lot of options for installing add-ons, extensions. Everything set up can be set up here. So we need a lot of time to explore this, but you can explore it on your own. Just go into each of the options: sharing, server-side encryption, file handling, mail templates, email server. So whenever some user is reaching its full quota, you can set it up that you should receive, as you are the admin, you should receive a mail from your server that someone is your hard disk is getting full. So you can set up some such custom alerts over email or something. So it all can be done from here. There is add-ons.
Add-ons are I think it's in the other. What's the specific?
One more thing. You have clients on Google Play, App Store, desktop app. One more thing. If you are using, if you want to download a client for your phone, for own cloud, on Play Store, it costs around 150 rupees. If you want to download it for free, go to fdroid.org, which Praveen showed us yesterday, and you can download the OpenCloud client for free. So move to App Stores, which only has open source apps. I guess my time is over, but we have got a lot of things covered. The things which are remaining are setting up the URL. You can't access this server now, right now, because if you try his IP, you won't be able to access it. So you have to edit a PHP configuration file, and you have to add his server's IP, whatever the IP that he wants to use for you to access. So that is remaining. The other thing is, you can only upload files up to 2 MB. So you can limit that. People should not upload full movies on the server. So you can limit the size of files that people would be uploading. So right now by default it is set to 2 MB. You need to learn how to make it 10 or 100 or 1 GB or 2 GB, whatever the size you want. So these two things are remaining, and I guess we have covered a lot of these things. The other thing, a lot of things are there to explore, and you need to learn it how to set it up on your desktop as for only for accessing files, not a server, just a own cloud sync client. So you place your files in some folder, it will automatically get uploaded to the server. So you will have a backup all the time. I guess that was it. Those who are remaining with the setups, you can join me somewhere else or join me later on. We'll finish the setup. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's almost finished.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.